Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Riverside Park. The Hudson Hawks against the Westboro Rangers had some technical difficulties to start the game, but ground ball to the shortstop, and that'll end the inning. That was Cooper Hagen, the pitcher for Westboro. And it was Connor Madden, the pitcher. Jared Colbert, alongside here, Cam Sezluk.
Happy to be here.
Yeah.
Getting things started, you know? It's a little chilly.
Yeah,
like a 40-degree day for our opening day, but, you know, it's okay.
Would have been nice. Right, yesterday was a great day.
Oh.
So not sure.
Yeah, I think it hit 70 yesterday.
So not sure what happened there.
I don't know who was scheduling this year. I don't know. Maybe they didn't check the weather report.
Right.
But that's okay. We're just excited that spring sports are here. And spring's here.
Oh, yeah.
And Riverside Park in great shape right out the gate.
Oh, yeah.
Looks beautiful out there.
Ice cream grass. I mean, even the dirt looks good.
This is what people come for.
Yeah. I mean... Oh, that was a little loud.
Just down here.
What? Oh.
Yep.
All right. Due up for Hudson, the catcher, Mikey DiCarlo. In center field, Jake Attaway. At short, Bobby Long. First base, Dan DeMijerin. Batting fifth to DH, Kalen O'Brien. In left, Teddy McFarland. In right, Brendan O'Brien. At third base, Garrett Giorgio. And at second base, in the nine hole, is Eddie Rodriguez, as mentioned. And the pitcher for Westboro is Cooper Hagen.
It's a squad right there.
Love the home whites.
Another year for head coach Tim Reinhart.
Yeah.
Crowd favorite.
Crowd favorite, and I'd say player favorite.
And, student favorite.
Student favorite.
Also a history teacher at the high school. Might have to just get that up a bit.
Now batting for
love to show off our center field camera, but once again, some technical difficulties here as Mikey DiCarlo steps up to the plate. 1-2-3 inning for the Hawks in the top of the frame, so still 0-0 here on this chilly Wednesday afternoon. First pitch is a strike to DiCarlo. Here we are. A one count. In there for another strike. 0-2 count to DiCarlo now. DiCarlo the catcher, and here's the 0-2 pitch. Hits it opposite way to the second baseman. He'll scoop it up. Get DiCarlo out in time. One away for the Rangers.
Number 8, center fielder Jake Attaway.
That was Andy Cerniglia, the second baseman, throwing it over to Connor Nagy. Ooh, Attaway hit by a pitch. And he's going to take first base here.
Now batting. Number 5.
That's going to bring up Bobby Long, the shortstop. An errant throw by Hagen. Nails Attaway. Bit of a pitcher's meeting. Catcher James Braden having a talk with his pitcher. And slowly and surely over the course of the game, I'll start remembering everyone's names instead of having to look it up. But Bobby Long, shortstop for the Hawks, up to the plate. We are working on getting a better signal from our camera in center field there. Jake Attaway on first. Lefty pitcher, so he has that quick pickoff attempt. Should he use it? And a swing and a miss for strike one on Bobby Long. There you go. Little staticky, a little grainy, but
435 out to there, so.
Yeah, we.
Anybody that knows TV production, that's it's a long distance for our cameras, but we're making it work.
Making it work, I think. Foul ball there by Long. Quickly 0-2.
I don't know where the pitch count is, Jared. That hasn't trickled down to high school sports yet?
No, not quite. And there's a ground ball to the shortstop. Double play opportunity. They'll just throw it straight to first. And we'll get him out there. Attaway able to beat it out to second base.
Now batting number 17, first baseman Dan DeMersion. So
fielder's choice there for Bobby Long. Now we have the left-handed Dan DeMersion, the first baseman.
Lefty on lefty
for the
here.
Hawks. He's going to ground it up the middle. Shortstop takes care of it, throws it first, and that's going to be three outs for the Rangers. Jake Dappolite, the shortstop for the Rangers, and they will strand Attaway. A quick first inning there for both the Hawks and the Rangers.
Yeah, not too much action, but you know, it's still early in the season, early in the game. We're not gonna rush it.
Right, hitters still getting a feel for being at bat.
Plus, I feel like in the cold weather, that bat just doesn't feel the same.
Doesn't pop.
Yeah, it's kind of dead. Your hands hurt after you swing, after you make contact. Like some of those groundouts just seem like just could tell it stung the hands.
Oh yeah, for sure.
So Jared, you're an old HHS baseball alum.
Yeah.
For Coach Reinhart.
Coach Reinhart played here, 2017. Saw some action 2016, but
nice.
Not too much. Well, not too much action in 2017 either, but I was on the team at least.
But you had some competitive teams, right?
Yeah, we snuck in on the playoffs on a technicality.
Nice. That's all it takes.
I think we won a couple games.
Lost
in the guessing it was the district semis must have been.
Right.
Those district finals would have been in Worcester.
Now batting for Westbrook.
And of course, I was back circa 2008-09.
Yeah.
And that was back in the Coach Davis days. Reinhart was on staff, but before he took over. And we had a couple good runs. I don't know if we were a playoff team, but good memories. He's going to miss with that first ball.
And this is third baseman Nick Delafato up to the plate. 1-0 count.
Ooh,
that's going to be down there for a strike.
HUD TV's in a new spot, kind of off behind the backstop here. And really gets you into the game, you know? We used to be out in left field.
Yeah.
That's good.
A little off-speed pitch right there. Yeah, I like it. See the whole field.
Really in it, you know?
I think I called a game from left field once, and I kept calling left field right field.
Yeah, it's
just because it was
feels backwards
flipped
out there.
But that mistake will not be made here. As the center field camera coming in and out, and ball three, make it a full count. We're just going to hope and pray for that center field camera here. That one's in the dirt. Piece. That one's hit to right. Tracking it well. He'll be under it for the first out. Right fielder, of course, Brendan O'Brien.
Right fielder, Owen Paraziak.
For the first out. Brendan O'Brien, wide receiver for the football team as well, which we saw him in action in the fall here at HUD TV.
Yeah, there's a few names that have transcended the sports seasons for HUD TV. And as long as that doesn't hit a camera, we are A-okay.
For Roy, it had a high enough arc. I thought it could have, well, he'd have to really have a high arc to come down on us. That's going to be grounded to the third baseman. Go across the diamond. The scoop. Beat out the throw.
That was close. Closer than I feel like that ump made it seem.
Giorgio couldn't quite get it across the field in time. It was a slow ground ball. Hard to beat out.
Right.
This is 13, Connor Nagy. Watch ball one. Kickoff attempt by Madden. But Tarasiak will get back in time.
Ooh, good poke.
Bounds a little bloop into the left center gap, but oh.
Gets it anyway.
McFarland dropped the ball coming in, but Tarasiak did not get anywhere close now to second batting, in time.
Number 22, the designated hitter.
That one just kind of worked out, you know?
Yeah, a net neutral error.
Right.
One of those funky plays, hard to read as a runner as well.
That one did seem like it was dipping fast, but he did get there in time. He could have caught it. Just kind of probably hit the palm of his glove. Popped right out.
Yeah, just kind of bounced out.
Good recovery, though.
Yeah, good awareness to know that you still have a play at second. And another high pitch, making a 2-0 count. This is Joe Marino, the designated hitter for the Westboro Rangers. In the 2-0 delivery.
Ooh, good spot.
That's going to be in there for strike one. Yeah, right at the knees. That's kind of where you want it.
Looked like a little bit outside, like on the outside of the plate. You're not gonna crush that ball.
That one just a little too low. Center field, it wants to come on.
I feel like it's this chain link we're dealing with. Ooh, good poke.
There's a hit to center field. He'll have it easily, though.
Can of corn. I don't know what that term is, but I've heard it before in baseball video games.
Oh, that was Attaway. Jake Attaway in center field.
Oh, yeah. Makes sense.
Underneath it.
Attaway is a HUD TV name that's been ringing all throughout the seasons.
Yeah, I mean, Pete Conti must have been sick of saying it.
Right.
Between football and basketball, he was involved a lot of plays as the league MVP quarterback. Some Taylor Swift here in between innings.
You gotta keep him on the toes, a little bit of everything. This is like old school Taylor too.
Yeah, I guess to mess with the opposing pitcher.
Yeah. Throwing pebbles.
Right. Really mess with his, getting in the zone.
Right. Just because he's going to be singing in his head, right?
Right.
Are you mid-transition here?
Oh. No, maybe.
Good.
It wasn't. Ooh. This wind.
Yeah, blowing towards left. Right across our bodies.
Just kind of see it in the flagpole right underneath the score bug there.
Now batting for Hudson, number 20, the designated hitter, Kalen O'Brien.
It's going to be Kalen O'Brien here for the Hawks. And he's going to drive one the other way to right field. Oh, he's going to drop it.
Ooh.
Kalen takes a turn, but he will be in safely at first base.
He thought about second.
Thought about second.
Thought about it hard.
Number nine.
But didn't fall far from the right fielder Tarasiak. But that will be an error, and Hawks runner at first for Teddy McFarland here.
Ooh.
Swing and a miss for McFarland.
That looked like it was almost a little off speed. He was ahead of that one.
They've just been a little too eager to get the season started, you know?
Yeah, first swings, you know, makes sense.
One pitch. Not a huge lead, so McFarland able to get back. One pitch. It's going to be a ball outside. 1-1. This is McFarland. O'Brien at first base. Wearing number 9, Ted Williams.
Mm-hmm. Ooh.
And that's going to be in there for strike 2. Hayden throwing well so far. These early innings.
It's kind of got a nonchalant delivery. Like it kind of slings it, and it doesn't seem like there's a whole lot of effort behind it. Comes in pretty good, but he's just kind of like, you know what I mean?
Yeah, bit of a, oh, and he's going to be rung up on strike 3 for McFarland.
Number 1, right fielder, Brendan O'Brien.
And here comes Brendan O'Brien up to the plate. But yeah, kind of has a 45-degree angle delivery almost. First pitch to O'Brien. Ball outside, off the glove. And the other O'Brien will easily get to second as this long backstop comes into play.
You know, I did catch on this field, and you do not want to have a pass ball.
Yeah, it is almost.
It is a long way to get back here.
It is almost a guarantee if it rolls to the fence. Now, runner on second. It's going to be tipped back.
It does line for a lot of catcher pop-ups, though.
Yeah, a lot of room to work with.
A lot of room.
Both good and bad for the offense. 1-1 pitch, runner stealing.
He's hosed.
Catcher's up and gunning, but O'Brien will be called out. That was James Braden, a catcher on the throw.
Yeah, it didn't look like he had the best jump.
I mean, a decent jump. It just looked like a fastball that
The delivery, too. His delivery's quick. It's nonchalant, but it's just like...
Right.
And that got home in a hurry, and then he got threw it down there with time to spare, I think.
Yeah. Aggressive base running so far here from the Hawks. Did not pay off, but...
Yeah, you know, try it early. See what happens.
That's going to be a ground ball. Third baseman will pick it up and get it over for the third out.
Inning.
Ended up being a quick one. Yeah, that was Bellofato, third baseman, able to scoop it up and get O'Brien out at first base.
Sorry, James.
Do you have any of those for me?
I can share a glove with you.
It's okay. my legs are coldest out of anything.
Legs, really? So, yeah, we got a slate of games kind of planned out, right? Some baseball,
yeah.
Some softball coming up.
Baseball, some softball. If you miss Pete Conti, be not afraid. He'll be there for the softball games.
Yep. We'll wrangle him in.
Yeah. I'm sure.
He's a perennial softball announcer.
Jump at the gun for that, yeah.
Maybe we'll throw a little lacrosse in as the season gets going, and at least a game a week, right? Pretty much.
I think more or less, yeah. Both baseball and softball all away next week.
Right.
And then it's the students' spring break, but they'll have a couple tournament games here. Get the name of the tournament off the top of my head, but
the Hearn tournament, I think.
The Hearn tournament. That's right.
And I think the softball one's something different, but
yeah.
So but yeah, those are something they do every year. It's always nice during the day, kind of during the week, during vacation week. It's a couple day games, a couple double headers.
Right.
So we get to the top of the third here. Catcher James Braden got the gun out. Bottom of the last inning.
Good spot.
It's going to be a ball
Ooh.
Inside. A little low. But definitely a good pitch still.
Didn't miss
the
by much.
Delivery. That's going to be
right up the pipe.
Man. Just popped out of the glove of DiCarlo there. Madden giving him a little pat on the chest plate there.
That's some of that early season. Just doesn't have it's not all polished up yet.
Right. And one of those things, cold weather, squeezing the glove a little bit harder.
It's a tough one.
You know.
You could see he was a little bummed.
Maybe the glove's not loosened up quite yet. Maybe it's a new glove. You know.
Right.
But a high swinging strike there. And off speed.
See, it didn't matter. Gets to pad his pitcher's stats.
Pad his stats, pick him up. Carlo, hopefully out of sight, out of mind.
Yep, you got to forget that mistake and move on, you know. Got the rest of the game to play.
As the Rangers number 9 hitter, Jared Gang, center fielder, will take ball one. And the 1-0 pitch. That's going to be pushed the opposite way up to the little picnic area they got going on over there. It used to be a playground. I don't know how long ago that was taken down.
Repurposing, maybe. A little brush back.
Ball inside. Keep the batter off his plate, you know?
Yep.
Not sure what they would repurpose that area for. It's not very big. Oh, that
maybe
was
they high. Could. I don't know. Do something with the cages. Do another another cage. Dog park. I don't know.
Could be just have your dog do tight laps.
Good spot.
And that one's going to be in there to
paint the corner on that
fill
one.
Up the count. I mean, right idea to lay off the batter, but great pitch.
Little nutty. Oh! It looks like he kind of stumbled coming off the dirt there onto the grass.
Yeah, maybe not
still
the best
jump. Still might have not gotten to it, but.
Yeah. It's a little blooper just out of reach. Out of reach of Giorgio. Over there on third base. Full count pitch.
Oh,
nice strike.
That was nice.
That is two punch outs here for Madden in the top of the third.
That one's tough to lay off. That little high heat on a full count. I mean, gutsy pitch because probably was out of the strike zone, but tough to let go by.
Yeah, looks good.
It looks good, yeah. And you're like, ooh, that was a little hot. I shouldn't have swung. Ooh, good piece.
And that one driven up the middle and will fall in for a base hit on the first pitch. That Cerniglia sees.
Now batting number 2. Shortstop.
Definition of a base hit right there. Right up the middle. Line drive.
Yep. Great piece of hitting.
Landed just in front of Attaway out there. not make a play on it. Now Rangers have a runner on with two out here in the top of the third.
Good spot, good spot. Gets a strike there.
First pitch strike here for Depolite. Pickoff attempt by Madden, but Cerniglia able to get back, and that's a high ball. 1-1, the count. The 1-1.
Ooh, nice pitch.
Off speed, almost in the dirt, but
curveball that just dropped right off the table.
Got Dapolite biting. He could go back to it here.
Yikes.
Ops for a fastball in the zone, foul back.
I have to say, where we're sitting, if we get one of those right at the fence, it's going to be a little jarring. That's all right. As long as it doesn't hit our stuff.
Right.
Ooh, hit and run.
Hit and run. Popped up to second base. And
handled easily.
Rodriguez able to get under it. Three outs for the Hawks. And they will leave a runner stranding. Zilch to zilch. Still here entering the bottom of the third.
Yeah, not a... That was one good hit in that inning. Or that half inning. And did they have the Hawks got a hit yet?
Well, I think they reached on an error to right field.
Yeah. So, got to get the bats going. That's another early season thing. Like, haven't seen a ton of live pitching to this point.
Right.
I think they maybe had a scrimmage, right?
They had a scrimmage. They took a trip to the Cape, I believe.
Oh, they did go to the Cape?
An overnight thing. I think just the one night.
Oh, nice. Yeah, that's always good to get some of that live gameplay. But it's still, even with that, it's still young in the season, and these are the games now that count, and just seeing that live pitching takes a little bit.
Right. I, for one, simply cannot wait for some 70-degree weather.
Oh, you know, we're putting in the time now here in this cold weather, and then we'll get rewarded with that 70-degree weather.
We put in the work in football season, in my opinion.
Well, the first, like, two games in football season, it's like, oh, this is nice. And then it's like it all rolls in, and you get the cold, and it gets dark sooner. And, yeah.
I mean, also, I was not there for those first couple games.
Oh, yeah, that's true. You caught the tail end of that.
And we took a trip to North Middlesex. I was cold.
Well, this kind of feels like that.
Yeah. Our 20-foot tripod here swaying in the wind a little bit.
Kinda.
A little top heavy, but it's got some strong legs, so I think we're fine.
Well, we're going to work it out.
That is a strike one for number 13, the third baseman, Giorgio. And that one a little low. A little windy out too, like we said. Can see the flag out in left field. And that one's going to be in there. 1-2 count. Just getting worse.
The wind.
Wind. There's the age-old debate of would you rather be too cold or too hot. And I, for one, am squarely in the too hot camp. I don't know what anyone is talking about.
Well, when I'm cold, I want to be too hot. When I'm hot, I want to be too cold.
No, when I'm hot, I can live with it.
The only thing is you can't escape the heat. At least when you're cold, you can layer up.
That's everyone says, but for example, my legs are cold right now. What can I do about it right this second? I'm out here and I'm freezing. That's the argument everyone uses. Oh, you can always layer up. But once you leave the house.
Well, that's on you.
You're high and dry. How many pairs of pants am I supposed to bring out?
Put your snow gear on.
I want to know count here for Rodriguez, the second baseman. Swing through that one.
Is it delayed? No.
No. It's fine. We'll go to it, see how long this lasts.
Yeah.
1-1 pitch.
If you got to take it off, take it off.
And there for strike two. Honestly, might need to look at it to see the strike zone a little bit better. Hard to see from this angle. And off speed. Plays off it. 2-2 count for Rodriguez. No one on, one out. Or scorebug says one out. Now one out. Three full count here. Payoff pitch.
Ooh.
And a little delayed.
He didn't like it, but he knew it was going to come and be a strike, so he tried to do something. But it was not a confident swing.
Right. Kind of realizing too late. Sort of a check swing, but then maybe realize, yeah, later that
wanted to like fight it off.
DiCarlo up to the plate. He's gonna watch strike one.
Two down for the Hawks.
Last inning at bat, almost.
Yeah. It's back,
but this is by far the more stable feed we have. I mean, in theory, we could run a thousand-foot cable.
I think we just got to get this transmitter out from behind the fence.
Yeah. And to stick it up.
Yeah.
Grip it.
Maybe we could attach it to the tripod somehow next time.
And timeout. Yo, two pitch to DiCarlo. And a good off speed pitch.
And that'll end the inning.
Quick 1-2-3 there for the Rangers.
Hey, I got a shout out to you for this these graphics and the scoreboard. New look for HUD TV. Yeah. You got all your outs, your on base, your count. For all you guys at home who are tuning in.
Yeah.
Jared Colbert making some magic with the graphics and all that info.
Yeah.
It's right there for your viewing pleasure.
I mean, it's only as good as the controller.
True, but again, it's early in the season. You're getting the hang of it. Yeah.
You know, it's cold outside. My hands are cold. I keep shoving.
You might hit the wrong key. Yeah,
maybe,
that's okay.
Maybe I miss a pitch because my hands are still in my pocket. But,
but well designed and, you know, looking forward to that the rest of the season.
Yeah, it should be great. You know, less work for us, too. We don't have to say everything all the time.
Yeah. Well, it's easier to keep track. There's a lot, right. Lot to – can't always see everything with baseball. It's a large field to try to cover with cameras. And,
right.
You know, you got your – who's on base, how many outs, all that right there on the screen for you.
And when we have the sick center field camera working and there's runners on the corner –
yeah.
That you wouldn't be able to see in frame.
Exactly.
It'll still be there on the screen for you.
Exactly.
And, of course, our HUD TV logo over there in the top right.
The baseball version.
Baseball version.
Nice little touch.
And softball version. It's just going to have to be both. They both look the same.
You just turn the ball green.
Yeah.
Now batting for Westbrook, number one, pitcher Cooper Hagen.
And now the pitcher Cooper Hagen up to the plate, try to help himself out here.
Ooh, good
and he's going to Driving the other way, just over the outstretched glove of Rodriguez. That'll find its way to the right fielder, Brendan O'Brien.
Tried to get up for that one, but especially as a second baseman, traditionally I feel like a shorter player.
Right. Just a little bit. I mean, it looked like he had the hops, but just out of reach, enough. Just too well placed of a hit.
Courtesy running at first base, Bruins star number 15, Justin McCaffrey.
Now they're ready to mess me up by throwing in substitutions here as Justin McCaffrey comes into pitch run for Hagen. Not sure if that means he'll have to come out of the game as the pitcher the rest of the way.
I don't think so. I think he can pinch run for the pitcher.
Some announcing we're doing here.
It's early in the season.
Early in the season. Early in the season, center field camera doesn't work all the time. We don't have a scorebook.
Gloves don't squeeze. The bats don't work. But we're here. Everybody's out here. You know.
Right. That's important. Fact is, we're here. Three people have shown up to watch. That's with no advertising whatsoever.
Right. Just stumbled on in.
Right. No tweets have been made. Maybe you found us through HUDTV.org. That'd be electric. And there's another two. Rodriguez.
Oh, good stab.
Diving stab, and he'll get the play at first. Accidentally cut away there, but great play by Rodriguez to keep the ball in the infield and at least get that one out. The runner will advance to second.
Yeah, he couldn't get to that first one that was over his head, but made a nice move on that one, laid out. Threw him out at first.
Right, pick himself up metaphorically by getting himself down physically.
Sometimes that's how it goes.
Right. And that's the message of, you know, the mental fortitude and picking yourself up in baseball game, because you might be called on to make the next play as this is popped up into foul territory. First baseman Demirjian had a play. He was out of the painted line, so really that was officially out of bounds. So I don't think that would have counted anyways.
But again, Riverside Park, a lot of foul territory behind the backstop and then beyond the fair foul line.
I mean, you can see here how much space is here on the first base side, and that extends all the way. It's that width all the way down.
Right. Same on the left. Ooh, hit by pitch.
Yeah, it is Madden. Now batting. Plunks the batter.
First baseman, Connor Hagen.
There you go.
First, getting there.
Oh, sorry. I thought you went to do it and it didn't work.
Oh, no. Got my system here for the base runners on the screen, and that's going to be strike one. Madden surely trying to pick himself up after that hit by pitch, able to get the first strike here.
A little outside.
As Nagy, first baseman, up to the plate. DiCarlo giving Madden a word. Off speed pitch grounded to the first baseman. He's trying for the play at second. He will get him.
Interesting choice. Getting that lead run, I guess.
22, designated hitter, Joe Marino.
First and third now, fielder's choice. But that is indeed two outs, and we're getting a little bit of precipitation. We have zero plan for if it starts to actually rain on all our equipment. We're just kind of hoping a little bit.
That's all we can do right now.
Hopefully, if it does start raining, hopefully they just call the game and we're able to pack everything up. But, yeah.
I mean, barring a downpour, we should be we should be okay. Get some resilient equipment. Got some resilient announcers.
Yeah. I mean, I just noticed that.
I know you're faltering a little bit in this chill.
I just noticed that Madden is going sleeveless here.
Oh, yeah.
As, I mean, I'm sure with the wind chill, we're dipping into the high 30s.
He's got the adrenaline, though. I think he's good.
Yeah. At pictures, I can see the argument for the long sleeves getting away. That one is high for ball two. But two outs, they do have that going for them. So anything will end the inning as the Rangers have a runner 90 feet away. Off speed, outside, 3-1 count. Favorable count for the hitter here, who is Jake Dapolite.
Good spot, good spot.
And that's going to fill up the count here. So, 3-2 count with two outs here in the nothing-nothing ball game in the top of the fourth. Delivery from Madden. Low in the zone and just a little too low. As that's going to fill him.
He had one to give there with that walk. Now the bases are loaded. Any ground ball, just touch a bag. Just need one out.
Yep. Base is loaded here. And that one's going to be fouled back.
Out of play.
This is Garrett Barrier. Pinch hitting for ISO. I believe Hagen was indeed taken out of the game. This is a pinch hitter. At least moved out of the pitcher's position. And it's quickly going to be 0-2. Madden getting some room to breathe here. Little outside.
Ooh, that was a close one. Looked pretty good.
Definitely looked good. Let's see if we can't get this angle for one of these pitches. The 1-2 pitch from Madden. Off speed, did he get him going? They tried to defer to the other umpire.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, kind of check swung on it. But no, I don't think it was that close.
And this one's hit high. Right fielder coming on, and they will get themselves out of the jam. Three stranded there in the top of the fourth for the Westboro Rangers. Stays a 0-0 ball game.
Yeah, good job by the Hawks squeaking out of that without letting up any runs.
Yeah.
He got a big hit there, and that would have cleared him.
Oh, for sure. I mean, especially he had the hit by pitch. He had the
walk.
By pitch walk. So confidence may have started to shake there in Madden, but able to get himself out of the jam. I'm going to stand just for loosen up the legs.
It's like a fourth inning stretch, you know?
Yeah.
Got a good jam on.
I mean, this game ends in the seventh, so.
Right, this is the fourth inning stretch.
Got to have to stretch somewhere. Get some blood flow.
Yeah, I feel like so many baseball games just start with, what a beautiful day here at Riverside Park.
Oh, yeah.
But
not.
Can't really say it today.
Can't say that today. Cloudy,
little rain, little
overcast,
little wind.
Yeah, do we have a? We have a weather report here. 42. Got a wind chill. Hold on.
Yeah,
our meteorologist a little slow on the report here. Officially 41, feels like 36.
That does feel like 36.
It certainly does. And 79% humidity. And we got a big, we can't show you folks home the radar, but.
But it's coming.
Big system coming in.
Big system. Got to get these, we got to put one run on the board and then get these outs flowing.
Right. Would be nice to get something going here for the Hawks in the bottom of the fourth. Running out of at-bats, but I believe this is the halfway point. No, the
now batting third, for Hudson,
halfway
eight,
between.
Yeah, a little past the halfway. Three and a half. And three and a half is seven. Math.
Right. No, but this is.
This is top four. This would be
the bottom four.
Right. Oh, bottom four.
But no, yeah, so that was the halfway point because we just did three innings plus the top of the other inning. So we got the bottom and then to go up to this.
Right.
Math, not our strong suit here at HUD TV. And swinging strike one.
Yeah, good cut, good cut.
This is Attaway. Up to the plate, the 0-1 pitch. And another big hack.
Ooh.
And that's a three pitch strikeout, swinging strikeout. And it is Hagen back out there on the pitcher's mound, so you're right.
Thanks.
The rules are a little...
Not my first high school baseball.
Right. <Just kidding. laughs> Rules are a little lenient at the high school level, I suppose. This is Bobby Long up to the plate.
Ooh.
Did that get him? No, just inside.
Just up and in a little bit.
That would have stung.
Oof, yeah.
Right on the arm.
Back of the arm and 36 degree. Feels like 36. Yeah, I got a sweatshirt dropped off. It was super clutch. Yeah. Super clutch for me. Ooh.
Oh, no, I tipped off the catcher's glove there. A 2-1 count. I mean, I did bring this in the car. I did have that.
You were ready. I was kind of on the fence about this whole thing. And
right. But even still, wish some gloves would have been nice. There is a high... pop up to the first base side, coming onto the dugout. Oh, just kind of lost it there. Unable to track it.
Our camera is picking up a little bit of that precipitation.
Yeah, a little bit of dew.
Few dots on there.
It's the 2-2 count here for Bobby Long.
Bobby Long.
That's a great name.
Classic name. I want a little roll.
In the dirt for ball three. We got ourselves a full count. Hudson just looking for some base runners here. The payoff pitch.
Oh, yeah.
Ground ball to between the shortstop and the third baseman. Unable to get it.
Good spot, good spot.
I'll take a look around first base, but settle for the single as the Hawks get a base runner.
Now batting number 17, first baseman.
Those hits don't feel quite as good as like that nice liner in the center that drops right in front of the center fielder. But always good to get a base hit.
Right. Hard hit nonetheless.
Yeah, right
in
the hole.
Found the gap in the infield.
If you're not going to hit a liner to center, then you might as well hit it hard in the hole.
Right. You'd rather that than a pop-up.
That's right.
As
at least make them make a play. They got to lay out or backhand that or do something, if they can even get to it.
I mean, even if the shortstop fielded it, as we got him stealing second here.
Ooh, safe. That throw came in a little low. Unable to pick it.
throws low, and I think he beat him anyway. Bit of an awkward slide, but I imagine the dirt's probably a little hard out
there. You know, it's still early in the season. Man, what are we going to talk about next game?
Right, by next game.
Ooh, chopper.
Trickler to the shortstop. Nice field. Long will advance, but they will get him out at second.
It's not necessarily an easy play, those choppers, but the shortstop hit that right at the right bounce, picked it, and able to make a nice clean throw over to first. Those ones can be hard to read.
Mistiming the hops as you're running in. The transfer from the glove to your hand, all a little tricky, but
well done.
There's a runner on third. There's foul ball.
See ya.
Towards the clubhouse. It's time like these where I wish the zero key wasn't so far away from the one and two keys.
Mm-hmm.
But that's just me.
A little base hit here would bring in a run.
Low pitch. Almost lost it in the dirt.
That'd have been a crazy way to get a run.
Yeah.
Pass ball in a 0-0 game.
Right. No contact made. It was just outside, and maybe the swing of the bat affected the catcher. But stayed on the dirt. We've got the 0-2 pitch here.
And good eye.
Going to take it high. Like you said, hard to lean off those kinds of pitches.
Yeah, sometimes you just want to try to fight it off, or, you know, it's hard not to swing at.
Right, you're trying to protect the zone. It looks pretty good, so give a layoff there.
Ooh.
And that one just outside, 2-2 count now.
That was another bold take. Well, I like it.
Kalen O'Brien, the DH.
Again, a base hit will bring in that run. Base hit or a pass ball.
Now pitcher Hagen running out of pitches to work with here. And he's going to fill it up. Pitching around O'Brien there, and now he's got himself a full count. Runner on third. Take a step back, check the runner.
Yeah, he's getting a nice little lead over there. I like it. Keep it aggressive.
Yep.
Maybe force a throw.
Payoff pitch. In the dirt.
Ooh.
Long thought about it. Just not. Hesitated just a little too much.
You can't. That's like a. If you could hold. If you could not hesitate there, I think he could have made it.
Yeah, I think it was just probably tough for him to see where the ball actually ended up behind the catcher.
He had a nice jump, but.
That classic Reinhardt third base lead where you creep down the
right.
Third
but
base
I mean, you're
line.
Halfway home by the time the pitch crosses the plate.
Yeah. But just couldn't get a read on where the ball ended up, and I think the cost him a couple steps, and by the time he realized where it was, catcher was already on top of it. But they did get the walk, runners on the corner. Catcher giving the infield their play should there be a steal to second.
Again, two outs, so you got to be a little bit careful.
Got to get a base hit, not just anything that scores a run. Ooh. First pitch to McFarland. He's going to be in there for strike one.
I think you got to try and make a throw him around, throw it around a little bit.
All right, we'll see if they have a double steal on or something.
That one low.
1-1 count. Bench became a lot more vocal as the game goes on.
Ooh, swing and a miss.
In the zone, but it'll be strike two. Come on, Madigan with the windup and the pitch. There's the steal, and it's a low.
They'll let him have second. Two runners in scoring position.
Now base hit, opportunity for a couple of runs, but you got to get that base hit. And out ends the inning. 2-2 pitch. Oh. High and swinging. Goes down on strikes.
Sugar.
And that's going to get rid of the threat that the Hawks had.
So both teams, I mean, Hawks got out of a loaded bases situation, and then Westboro just able to get out of that. Two runners in scoring position, get the strikeout. That's how it goes.
Yeah, they're just, seems like every inning first batter gets out. And hard to just get, you know, hit after hit when you have an out, when you have two outs. Really puts the pressure on.
It's true.
So cannot stress enough the importance of that first batter getting on base, giving you a little bit more room to work.
Yep. All right, Jared, here's some trivia for you.
All right.
What are the seven ways you can get on first base?
The seven ways.
Yep.
All right. Is it like hit or is it single?
It's a hit.
Hit. A walk.
Yep.
A dropped third strike.
Yep.
Are we separating hit by pitches?
Hit by pitch.
Drop third strike, hit walk, hit by pitch. Bach when it moves.
Now batting for Westboro. Number eight.
We'll get back to the next half inning.
I got three more to go. Maybe we'll see one of those happen here. Dang, feels like something I should have been able to get. But alas, the top of the fifth here. Madden still on the mound, and there's going to be a fly ball to Attaway, and he gets under it for the first out.
Now batting number five. Second
I'm going to be off my game because in the back of my head,
just work on this in the subconscious.
I'm going to be racking my brain. And ball one. I think next outing, definitely a paper and pen version of the lineups.
Yeah.
Would be nice. That's in for ball two. Maybe we get one of those score books.
There you go.
No clue where you get
maybe
that.
There's a digital one from the team we can use. Maybe they've got it going.
I did download an app on the iPad here, but not enough time pregame to
get it squared
start
away.
Filling it out. There's strike one. 3-1 count here. And that's going to be inside. Oof. And walk.
It's always a tough one to get that that first batter walk. Now they can, matriculate.
Well, there's the flyout to center.
Oh, right.
That was the second batter. But still, an early inning walk.
Early inning walk.
Still hurts a little bit.
Allows you to get that runner over with some situational baseball.
But like we said, they did get that first out, so now options are a little bit more limited. And Madden struggling a little bit to find the strike zone right now. Checks the runner. Decent throw over, but runner able to get back no problem. 2-0 pitch.
Ooh, that one looks good.
Going to be in there for strike one. And also, there's some double play opportunity here.
True. That one didn't miss by much.
Give me a 3-1 count now. And with the pitch, runners going, ground ball, hit and run. And ooh, there's a gap. Runner's going to head to third. Able to keep.
It was a good play there by Westbro.
Batter at first. They have the hit run on. So even with the first batter out, they're able to pull something off. The steal pulled the shortstop over. Great job by the batter to find that wide open gap. So now runners at the corner. As it is the pitcher Cooper Hagen up to bat. First pitch, swinging strike.
Good pop on that one.
A little bit of heat. One pitch.
A little high.
A little high. Could have been in there, but ump said no. We'll see if Westbro tries a steal here.
Ooh,
there's
up
a high fly into kind of no man's land out and right.
Oh, come on. Somebody's got to lay out for that.
Foul ball. It's kind of the...
I guess it was in a tough spot.
If he took the furthest point between the first baseman and the right fielder, that was probably it.
Yeah. I always liked those, though, because you could lay out, and if you don't catch it, it's still a foul.
Doesn't matter.
So you got to just sell out over there, as long as you don't hit the walkway.
Right.
The pavement.
1-2 pitch.
Ooh.
Check swing. You'll tip it just barely.
I think that was in there. If he didn't get a piece of that,
I think it was. Umpire hand delivered the new ball to.
That's what you call service, you know. I went above and beyond there.
One, two again.
Good spot.
Low to the third baseman. That's going to be fair ball. Hit the bag, and everyone will be safe.
That's tough.
And we get our first run of the game.
Now batting number 4, third baseman, Nick Dalafato.
Bummer. That was just it was just right.
It hit the bag. Couldn't wait any longer for it to go to be a foul ball, and it was kind of a low or a soft grounder, so it couldn't really charge it and make much of a play.
Yeah, even if that didn't hit the bag and he could have fielded it cleanly, the speed of it and where it was would have been a tough throw.
Yeah, I mean, at best you're getting the runner out at first.
Right.
And you're still conceding that run. So you have a
almost like a bunt
count. Yeah, served the same purpose.
Poked out to left. Look out over there.
Having a bit of a crowd there. That seems to be the popular spot along the left field line.
Yeah, we get some Hudson faithful showing up today. Runners off.
Pitch, runners off. Gunning.
Ooh. Oh. You're calling him safe.
Called him safe at third.
Maybe he was safe, but that was right and there.
Dove head first. It was a bang bang play. Tough to tell.
Maybe we'll slow that down later on. Go back through the footage.
Do not have that
ripped.
There's a shot. It's gonna land behind the right fielder.
Oh, that's trouble. That's a triple or double.
A standing double for Belafonte.
The gates have opened here in the top of the fifth.
A base clearing double.
Number 9, right fielder, Owen Tarazio.
Coach Reinhardt's going to go ahead and have a word. 3 runs on the board. For Westbro. We got somebody warming in the bullpen.
We got number 11, David Rosengard in the pen. No bullpen cam for us to show you.
We'll work on that.
We're working on it. Could be. Never even thought about that until just now. How sick that would be. We might have something that could help with that.
Yeah.
But for now, just
keep tuning in. Ooh, buzzed him.
For now, Madden's still in the game.
Watch your chin. That was right up in there.
1-0 count, runner on second, still one out.
A little low on that one.
Madden right now struggling to find the zone, just struggling in general. Probably a little shaken after those past couple of big plays.
I mean, that was a rip to right.
Just out of reach.
I think that's the most common foul ball trajectory for a righty. Is right over there and it hits the pavement to the clubhouse. Which is as long as we're not in that line of fire.
All
right. Here it is, same spot. Right to the pavement. A little left.
Oh, hit the tree. which is a little worrying because this is where our camera is on this side, but they seem to be pushing it a lot further than where our camera is stationed. But 2-2 count now. Off speed. Got to get him on a knee.
Good pitch. There's two outs here.
Now batting number 13.
And a lefty.
Connor Nagy.
Connor Nagy up to the plate. The runner on second. Steal attempt.
Bang.
Looked like he
posed him.
Forgot to switch back. Looked like he got a hand on it at first, but I think his hand popped up when he hit the bag.
Nice throw there by Mikey DiCarlo.
Great throw by DiCarlo to get the out, but damage was done. Westbro 3, Hudson still 0. As we approach the bottom of the fifth, three more attempts for the Hawks.
Yeah, so that was a big inning there.
Huge inning for Westbro. I mean, especially with how the first bunch of innings have been going. Seemed to be
right.
Pitcher, defense, duel.
All right, so the next three you have left are a little bit more technical.
Right.
So you got hit, you got hit by pitch, you got a walk, and dropped third strike.
Yeah.
There are three more.
Okay.
One's kind of obvious. Well, not obvious, but... more routine.
Well, there's an error.
An error, yes. That's fine. I
almost forgot about that. I'm just trying to think different things you would write in the scorebook that would constitute a different way of reaching first. So we have five, so we have the error. Fielder's choice.
Fielder's choice, yep.
Fielder's choice. And, all right.
Last one's probably the most technical.
Okay. I'm going to start running through some scenarios. So you hit the ball, it lands safely, get him first.
Now,
hit. You hit the ball,
one, right
fielder gets someone else out. That's fielder's choice. Hit the ball, dropped it, that's an error. Hit the ball. I don't know what other options between.
Stay tuned for the sixth inning stretch. You'll find the last one.
can't believe a frat error in fielder's choice. First time around.
That's all right.
Anyways, pitch, a little blooper of a hit.
It was almost like a bunt again, but that one they're able to throw him out.
Hagen fielded cleanly with enough time
number 13,
to get that out.
Garrett Giorgio.
Third baseman Giorgio up to the plate.
Giorgio must have a sister on the basketball team, right?
Could be.
Or a cousin or something?
Something.
We were saying that name a lot.
I think I went to school with the Giorgio. Maybe it's a big family here in Hudson. I don't know.
There you go.
But quickly 0-2 now. Once we get some sideline reporters, we'll be able to get that information.
That's right.
Ooh. And swinging strike three. Hawks quickly two outs.
Now batting number four, second baseman Eddie Rodriguez.
Just when they needed something, some kind of drawn out inning to put some pressure on Westboro, quickly find themselves in the hole. Two outs here in the bottom of the fifth. Comes out swinging again. Hawks eager to put the bat on the ball.
Yeah, they have been swinging, which is good. They haven't been looking at pitches, but haven't been a whole lot of hits. There's a piece.
Piece tipped back for strike two. Right, as good as swinging the ball is, you do have to make contact.
Swing the bat.
It's early in the season. Yeah. Oh, and an off speed. Drop third. They'll make the play, though.
It's good that the catcher's glove didn't touch his swing, though.
Yeah. So that would have been catcher's interference. which would have been the seventh thing to get you on base.
I don't know. Are we going to get it? That's a tough one. That's like a – you don't think of that one.
Right. Oh, there you go. Slipping into conversation there. You said it. And I was like, why would even – was it that close of a play?
That's a good little trivia, right?
Yeah, it was.
Well, we're going to keep that up, little baseball trivia.
Look at you with the baseball trivia. Rolling.
Check.
Check 1-2.
All right.
Welcome back from technical difficulties.
Yeah. If you were watching live when we were recording this, sorry it cut out. Won't happen again. But hopefully you're tuning in to see the end here. After the fact, but we're at the top of the sixth, bottom of the sixth, and the Hawks are getting some things going with the bats. So join us back in here. One out, bottom six, Hawks down three.
First baseman Dan Demersian.
So a little extra work for you, Jared, to put this together, but
extra work. Probably won't put a score bug up at the end. Maybe just the score.
Yeah. But it's early in the season.
We're
doing the best. We're doing the best we can. Ooh, slicing.
Foul ball. 0-1 count here. Runners on second and third, one out. So pressure's on. Fly ball can score a run or a ground ball, so it's the 0-1 pitch, low in the dirt. They get 1-1.
Yeah, last time the Hawks were in this position, they had two outs. And now they've got more.
And there's a
good poke.
Deep hit. Center fielder coming on. It's going to land in front of him and roll a bit back. One run scores. They're waving in another. Batter safe at second, and two runs will score.
Nice.
Hawks make it a one-run game here in the bottom of the sixth. With a double by Demirjian.
One run game, yeah. Things getting
game.
Getting intense.
As it's winding it down. Yep, that laptop is dead.
Jeez. We're gonna have to get you like a battery pack or something.
Bring out the desktop every time. Man. But yeah.
I have to run some diagnostics on that. See what's going down. Could have been that whatever the charging port wasn't connected. Or did you see it was charging?
At one point I did, but it was I think it was the symbol where it knows it's plugged in, but it's still using battery.
Oh, yeah.
So I don't know.
Well.
Just one of those things. You know, early in the season, we'll work out the kinks.
That's right.
And, you know, presumably next time we have technical difficulties, it'll at least be warmer.
Right.
So we're happier about it anyways.
It's true.
It's cold and the stream stopped working, so, you know, everything's working against us.
It's true.
So we had a pitching change here. In comes number two.
Number two.
Let's see how Merck pronounces it. Dappolite.
Dappolite.
I believe that's how I've been saying it. Jake Dappolite. He was a shortstop coming into pitch. As Hawks putting some pressure on, still only one out. Runner at second.
Designated hitter Kalen O'Brien.
Now here comes Kalen O'Brien to hit. Runner dancing around second there. Pitch low and outside. 1-0 count for O'Brien. I like our little side-to-side sway we're both doing.
It's necessary.
Keep Ooh. The feet warm. That one's tipped high. Onto the pavement.
Yep. Ooh. Classic. Hit the fence.
Fence. Makes it easier for the... Oh, he doesn't know where it went. Oh, 2 count. Off Ooh. Speed. Almost got in there. A little bit inside.
Had a little bend to it.
One of those things that would have been nice to have in high school, a little curveball.
Yeah.
And that Ooh. One, he just kind of pokes it. Runner able to advance, swinging bunt.
Another perfect bunt.
For Kalen O'Brien, you couldn't bunt that better if you were squared up.
Right past the pitcher, too far away for the shortstop.
Number 11.
Really? Yeah, that sweet spot. Past the pitcher, but in front of the shortstop, where neither can really make the play. Runner able to advance right away.
So the go-ahead run is on first.
Still one out here in the bottom of the sixth.
Chance to...
Teddy McFarland.
Hitting?
Hitting.
No, I think it's Rosengard.
Oh. We have a substitution here. Yep, David Rosengard.
David Rosengard, who's also going to be pitching, perhaps. He was warming in the bullpen. He's going to bloop it into right. It's getting play. Down.
It's coming on. Yeah. It's going to land out in right field. They have a play at second. He'll drop it. Safe
and
at
run
second.
Scores.
A run will score. O'Brien safe at second. And Rosenberg. Bloop single. That's a hit.
That's a hit. Yeah. It's one of the ways you can get on.
Right. Not catcher interference.
Now batting, number 1, right fielder.
And we have a tie ball game with the winning run now, or the leading run now in scoring position. As it's Brendan O'Brien up to the plate. Kalen O'Brien at second and Rosenberg at first. And that one is low and away.
So Hawks potentially a base hit away if he can score from second.
Certainly has the lead. The second baseman for Rangers keeping him on. It's going to be in there for strike.
That one looked hittable.
One. Looked pretty good.
I mean, I didn't want to.
Thought so too. That's right. Why he called it a strike.
O'Brien could not have been bothered though. Said, get that out of here. That's not for me. And he's going to watch that one go by, too.
All alone in the zone.
Make this guy throw some pitches.
Yeah, make them work for him.
Yeah.
But now two strikes on. We're protecting the plate here. The 1-2 count. That one's
gotta move. Gotta move.
Away. Runners both able to advance standing.
Go ahead, run 90 feet away. Let's go.
A couple of ducks on the pond here for Brendan O'Brien. Now,
As they say.
Hawks bench up on its feet. Hawks dugout.
If we're out of sync, we're going to start bumping in there.
Double in trouble now. The 2-2 pitch. Brendan O'Brien went for it, but he's going to ring him up. Strike three called on Brendan O'Brien.
Now batting number 13, third baseman Garrett Giorgio.
Now here comes the third baseman Garrett Giorgio. Still a couple of ducks in the pond. Love that phrase.
Yeah, no, it's great.
Never not take the opportunity.
Great imagery, you know. Ooh, they just don't want to swing at those good right down the pipelines. Yeah,
they follow it all the way through and then just lay off. Kind of deciding early on that's not their pitch and choose not to say that one pushed the opposite way.
Over to the playground.
To the playground that once was the plot of land formerly known as
Playground.
But Garrett quickly down 0-2. That one in the zone.
Again.
That one's up. Out of play. Onto the exit of this parking lot.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Anyone trying to beat the traffic?
Look out.
Yeah.
Got a piece. Speed.
Got a tip.
Got a piece. Staying alive.
Still in it. Still 0-2. A couple foul balls down here. That one just barely a piece. Catcher couldn't hold on to it. And live to see another pitch here. From pitcher here. That one, once again.
Another piece.
Straight back. Dapolite trying to put away Giorgio. Giorgio still in it though, still battling. Got some good hacks in.
Just put it in play. Put it in play. Make a play. At least you got a shot at getting that run in. Yes.
Off speed, and that's going to be a bloop. Shortstop heading back over his
shoulder. Ooh.
It's going to drop. And two runs will score.
Huge hit.
Giorgio getting a bloop single here.
Two RBIs. To take the lead.
Runners running on contact there. They had plenty of time to come around.
Intending for Hudson, number 12, Riley O'Sullivan.
Not quite sure who's out there at short right now for the Rangers, as it was Dapolite's position to start the game.
I wonder if Dapolite might have made that play. He seemed like a pretty spry shortstop.
You got to wonder. I mean, if he's, you know, their shortstop pitcher, you got to think he's a good athlete. Obviously, they're starting shortstop. So, curious thing to think about.
I'd say so. But with that, in the top of, or bottom of the sixth, Hawks take the lead, which really just means they got to get three outs.
Right.
Five. This one closes it up.
With five-run inning here for the Hawks. It's not over yet.
I mean, if you're going to take the lead in a game, bottom of the sixth is a good time to do it.
As Rodriguez flicks one foul.
I've got a good shiver starting.
Yeah, one of those days.
After six good innings.
Right, feet are getting a little cold, so I would greatly appreciate it if the Hawks have a 1-2-3 top of the seventh.
Right.
Rodriguez 0-2, he puts it in play. Second baseman going to get there, collect himself, and that's through. Dropped by the first baseman. Giorgio going to get all the way to third base.
Throwing error.
Rodriguez finds himself top second.
Now batting number six.
Dapolite, is that what's the pitcher's name?
Dapolite.
Dapolite thought he got out of this inning. And
two in a row.
He's back at it.
0-2 counts, couple of foul balls, and Hawks batter is able to get a piece of it, put the ball in play, and good things happen.
That's right.
Loop single, error by the.
That was a tough.
That was a throwing or a catching error by the first baseman.
He did have to range quite a way to field that ball, and the runner was close. So he rushed that throw, came in a little low. First baseman couldn't grab it.
And now starting this at bat the opposite way with a 2-0 count. DiCarlo up to the plate. That one inside but in the zone. 2-1 count now. Carlo, the leadoff hitter, takes the time, bucks himself. Once again, two runners in scoring position. I mean, they can just really blow it open here. And this one, Giorgio opting not to go. It skipped a little ways away, but.
Catcher just did everything he could to get a glove on that and knock that down.
All right. Kind of pushed it off to the side, made sure it didn't get by him.
Right.
And saved a run there. But a 3-1 count for DiCarlo. The pitch, thought he had a good one, but was ahead of it. Now, full count. Giorgio on third, Rodriguez on second. The full the payoff pitch. Outside. DiCarlo got to find himself on first base.
Base is loaded for
Jake Attaway.
He's been a pretty clutch player in other sports. Let's see if he can come up with something here. Ooh, that's.
Someone stung. Foul.
Thought that went over the bag. That was ripped.
Just a little bit too much.
Hey, QB1. I'll never get away from that in the next couple of years here. Great football player.
You win a league MVP in as a sport, you're probably going to be known for that particular sport.
Right. As a sophomore, too.
Even when you're up to plate. In a baseball game. That one hit towards a shortstop. He has options. They go to second, but he's safe. And he stayed running in a pickle now. They're trying to get a second run to score. Two will score. And it's not a force out, so those two will count. And he's going to be safe at third. Runner back to second. He's going to be safe.
It is chaos on the diamond.
Two runs will score here, and everyone is standing up. Safe. The inning.
Wow.
Over. Some base running trickery by the Hawks.
Well done.
Number five.
Opted not to slide into second and just kind of kept running, and the throw was too late.
That was awesome.
And by the time the second baseman checked with the umpire whether or not it was out or safe, DiCarlo was halfway down to third.
What a move.
Got himself in a pickle. Another run scored. He got himself safe. And Attaway able to get himself to second base as we start with a 1-0 count.
That's huge. A one-run lead. I mean, they could manufacture a run in the top of the seventh, but getting a four-run, really a seven-run inning, right?
Yeah, seven-run inning.
That's huge. Seven-run, sixth, top of the, or bottom of the sixth. It's huge.
Four of those with two outs as well. That one's in there for this first strike at the at bat. But I mean, DiCarlo, incredible job not taking the force out, because that would have just, no runs would have scored. But getting himself in the pickle, at least securing those two runs.
Right.
But then, of course, himself getting safe and Attaway advancing to second in all the kerfuffle.
Right. I don't know if that pitching change for Westboro was a good call.
Maybe they sacrificed some defense out there in seemingly a crucial position. As Bobby Long fouls that one off.
It's funny too, the Hawks haven't had, like, you know, any big hit doubles or anything like that. It's kind of been this, like, just small ball, getting it done, doing it on the base paths, and just putting the ball in play.
Absolutely. Dinks and dunks and
error of that, I mean, oh, that throwing error at first.
Forcing Westbro to make a play, and he's going to walk and fill up the bases.
Now batting number 17, first baseman Dan Demersion.
And Dan Demersion up to the plate. Left-hander here, cleanup hitter.
Oh, wow.
In exactly the spot you want him in, with the bases loaded. And that's a strike.
Okay.
We got a surprise announcer here in the booth. Well, at the table.
Oh, good
and
knock.
A big hit. That's going to land.
They're going to score
right
some runs.
One's going to score. Here comes Attaway. He's around. And a runner at third as well. Long advances to third. Carlo and Attaway score.
This microphone.
Why? What? What? What?
For the game. We're calling the game.
Now batting number 20, designated hitter Kaylin O'Brien.
They were in a pickle.
They were in a pickle, that's right. And they scored a run. Got some help in the booth here.
Help in the booth, breaking down that last play. That
saw that pickle over at third base.
Yeah.
You saw the pickle?
No.
You're a pickle.
All of a sudden, it's a nine-run inning for the Hawks, first and third.
Nine runs in one inning.
Now it's Kaylin O'Brien back up to the plate. Once inning still not over, runner on third. Allen high, take a big hack and miss. Well, I do appreciate the Hawks running up the score. I think they're good.
I think that's enough of a lead.
We can move on. Try to get out of this. And 2-2 count to O'Brien. Approaching 2 hours of game time here. That one way outside, but a swinging drop third strike. And everyone is safe again.
Unbelievable.
Wow. O'Brien, not sure if he was swinging anyways and just because he liked it or if he knew that was going to be a drop third strike or what. But swung in it.
That was probably a really good call. Yeah. Kept the inning alive again.
Yeah. Like that, 10-3 Hawks. That one high.
He's just frustrated.
I mean, he came in for relief. You expect a fresh arm, you know, kind of clean up the game, but
he's getting shelled.
Dabble eat. There is activity in the Rangers pen. And that one's gonna get stung off the glove of the third baseman.
Oh, send him.
Just too short.
Oh.
And he knocked it down, at least.
I thought
kept
that
it
was
in the infield.
I thought that was going in the left. That was a good knockdown.
Barely just didn't roll that far.
Number one, right fielder, Brendan O'Brien.
And Hawks find themselves with the bases loaded.
Hawks have batted around and then some.
Yeah. Brendan O'Brien, at least Kaylin O'Brien.
Yeah. I think Brendan O'Brien made one of the outs earlier.
Yeah. As
might be dirty.
Will be a pitching change.
Check.
For the Westboro Rangers.
Number 22, Joe Marino.
And it's going to be Joe Marino for the Westboro Rangers. Was the designated hitter. There, we're going to bring him in. Give him a chance to warm up, and then it's Brendan O'Brien's turn to bat with the bases loaded here in the bottom of the sixth. two outs in the 10-3 ball game.
Can't believe
Hudson at first base.
This would have been happy.
This would have been great to have live. Really would have been a cool product to put out to the world.
Right.
There will be some version of it on Vimeo at the end of the day. Well, not at the end of today, but when all is said and done. So if you did check our Vimeo, catch the game this way, thanks for tuning in. Next time for sure.
Work out that kink.
Get a full live stream going. I mean, I thought it was working pretty well. Center field camera could have been transmitted a little better.
Couple kinks. Work out those couple kinks.
But end of the day, 10-3 ball game. Ball one to Brendan O'Brien. Pitch from Marino.
I don't know if this is better.
Joe Marino was the DH, was in the lineup as the DH. They bring him in. And that's going to be three straight balls to start off Marino's outing.
Getting a little look at the depth of pitching from Westbrook.
And O'Brien happy to just watch that one, force Marino to throw a strike. Bases loaded for the Hawks. The 3-1 pitch. That one's high and in, walks a run. Hawks 11-3.
Just really broke right open, didn't it?
Just piling on.
Number 13.
That's all it takes in baseball. You just need one good inning where the bats are rolling.
Yeah.
And then you're right off of that.
Starts off with a strike this time.
As in is Giorgio.
Yeah, Giorgio had that hit, the go-ahead hit.
Yeah. Right, the little bloop single over the shortstop.
Yeah.
Not too long
to
ago.
To take the lead, and then it's just been chaos. Hijinks ensue.
Right. 1-1 count. George, you're able to piece it away. It's going to hit. That's an out.
Dang. Odd way to end that one.
Live ball hit the base runner. Really unfortunate. I mean, that was stung the other way.
Duck or
the
something.
Gap between the second baseman and first. That was going to roll into the outfield. At least a couple runs there. But
I feel like
I think they did pretty good this inning. I don't know, even with that mishap at the end.
Sure.
Leaving them stranded.
But a little dodge or like a duck, a dip, a dive.
I mean, it's
or another dodge.
It's hard because two outs, bases are loaded. You're running on contact, so you hear the contact, so you start running.
True. Stepped right into it. Right. That was a hard hit ball too. It wasn't like was like a blooped right at him.
Right. Not even a ground ball you can jump over. But they got 11. That'll have to do.
Yeah. And O'Brien got hit, and now he's hitting the mound.
How does that play get scored? You know?
I don't know. I don't know.
Yeah, not quite sure what that W score is. I think it just as if someone got tagged out during the play or something. So I think
it's like a force out or something.
Yeah, I think it just runner out. Probably still give the. I don't know if that's a single to O'Brien.
I don't know.
Sure.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Okay.
Yeah, probably just mark it as the runner got out.
So Hawks three outs away.
How we became the authority on. I know we have the headsets on. It seemed like we know what we're doing.
We're not live.
We're not live.
I don't know how you could tell, but.
All right, Hawks need three out to close this one out. One inning ago, they found themselves down. But Here they are up 11-3, and it's going to be Teddy McFarland.
It's popped up way out of bounds.
Out of play. I didn't even see that one land.
It's over behind the tree.
Oh, that guy ran by it.
Just missed.
You know, 1-2 count. McFarland with the delivery. Ball low.
O'Brien, right?
Who?
Oh, the pitcher.
Number 9, McFarland. That's grounded short. And there's the first out of the inning. Rangers down to their last two with a lot of ground to cover.
Second baseman, Andy Cerniglia.
That's not O'Brien?
That is.
Like wide receiver?
Number 9, Teddy McFarland. According to the information I have.
Down?
I mean, I guess they have the same hair, but I think that's still O'Brien out and right.
Oh. Oh, all right.
And that's in their first strike one. It's Andy Cerniglia up to bat. Watches that one in the dirt for ball two. Pitch in the dirt again, makes it 3-1. A lot of Hawks opted for no sleeves, I feel like. And that one
gets a walk.
Low in a way for the walk.
Number 2.
As we are down to 34 degrees with wind chill and a 7-mile-per-hour wind to the west to the third base side.
A couple ground outs here.
I mean, really, one ground out could end the game. McFarland throwing up high, though. This is Dapolitz, I believe, unless they subbed him out. Yes, Dapolitz, number 2. So they might have moved him back to short. 2-0 count. That one's hit hard.
Hooked out to Attaway.
Center field. Attaway looks comfortable out there and gets under it. Gets there for out number 2.
Now batting number 1, center fielder Cooper Hagen.
So runner on for the Rangers, but they are down to their last out. And it's Cooper Hagen up to the plate. Hawks not checking that runner on first at all. They're happy to let him run around. And this one's blooped into right. O'Brien on the run. He's going to get
there. Oh, yeah,
there.
That is O'Brien. Good call. I knew you were sharp.
Right. He's going to get there for the last out. And that's going to do it here from Godotti Field. Godotti Field here at Riverside
Park.
Godotti Field. Here at Riverside Park.
Right.
Here at Hudson High. So that's going to do it. Hawks get the win. Open up their season with the W. 11-3 is your final score. I've been Jared Colbert alongside Cam Suzuk. Thanks for watching, and we will catch you next time.